welcome to ITC Tech Share. I'm Tom Grissom. Today, I would like to show you how I start a view-only OneNote notebook. So we're about to begin a new semester here at EIU, and one of the things that I typically do is to make a shared OneNote notebook. That way, whenever I do presentations and demos and things, I can make my notes out in the OneNote notebook and share this publicly with the students or faculty, whoever happen to be giving the presentation to. So we're going to start from our Office 365 splash screen right here, and we're going to put this to OneDrive because it is going to be a shared notebook, so it must be stored in the cloud. So let me open up my OneDrive, and you will see my file structure organization here, and I do things by academic year. So I'm going to open up the AY1718 folder, and once that's open, you'll see that I have various subfolders. I have a separate subfolder named OneNote Notebooks. So if I open up this notebook, this shows you some of the different notebooks that I have available. Now we're starting a new academic year, so there's not very many here yet. But I'm going to go up here. Now that I'm in my AY1718 OneNote Notebooks, these are the breadcrumbs that you can trace. So go to the folder that you want to create the notebook in, click on the New button. We want to make a OneNote notebook, so make that selection. And now it's asking us for a name. So this is for the fall semester, so I'm going to call this ITC Fall 2017 Semester. Okay, double check the name, make sure it's everything spelled correctly. Don't put any special symbols or anything in this, just alphanumeric. And then I'm going to hit Create. ITC Fall 2017 Semester, one last check. Hit Create. Now then, it's going out to Office 365 servers and actually creating this notebook, and that happened very, very quickly. Depending upon the load the servers are experiencing, it may take a little bit longer than that. That was very, very quick. So here I am, as typical. I've got my sections over here in the left-hand column. Next to that are my pages. So I'm going to right-click where it says Untitled Section, and I'm going to rename this section and make this something a little bit more appropriate. Since the main purpose of this is for demos, projects, well, let's do demos, presentations, and projects. I like to keep these fairly short. That's about as long as I would want to go. Otherwise, you're not going to see the full name. So once again, double check. Demos, presentations, and projects. Yes, that's what I want to do. And then you see that it's renamed here. Now I'm going to make another section. So I'm going to hit the plus section. That will create a new section. And I like to have an about this notebook. Okay. About this notebook section. That's okay. And then let's make one more section. So if somebody comes to this notebook and they're not familiar with OneNote, I usually like to make a section called Getting Started with OneNote. And OneNote's just a digital three-ring binder. It's very easy to use, just a brief overview, and most students and faculties are quite comfortable with it. So Getting Started with OneNote, I'll say OK. Now you will also notice that these are color-coded. You can right-click on this and change the color to whatever you would like, but that's kind of a nice feature. If I go back to the About This Notebook, I have one open already from my ITC Spring 2017 semester. So rather than reinvent the wheel, I can just copy and paste this. Looks like I left my T off there. Let's grab the full paragraph here. Right-click, copy. And then go back into About, and I'll just click here anywhere on this. Remember, it's a blank canvas, so I can click anywhere on this. Typically, I go in the upper left. That's what most people are accustomed to. And instead of this being the fall 2016 semester, that's one I did a year ago. I'll just change that to 2017. And then I'll come in and clean this up and put the appropriate, you know, time appropriate comments and things. My demos, projects, and presentations, the way I typically do this is you'll see that it puts a date and time stamp. I usually put the date as kind of a marker for chronological purposes. So 07/26/2017. And I'm just going to say demo. Presentation one. And then I can come down here, type in my notes, and do whatever I would like to do. All right, so that's the basic structure. So I've got some three different sections out here. I can add pages at will whenever I need it. The one that is uppermost on the top, your top section, that is the one that if you share a view only link, your viewer is always going to land on that particular section and then whatever is the top page. So that's why I like to keep things chronological from the top down, with the top being the most recent demos or presentations that I'm doing. So that's just a quick overview. That's how easy it is. We went out to OneDrive. We went to our OneNote notebook subfolder, created a new OneNote notebook called ITC Fall 2017 Semester, and created three sections, and we're off and running. In the next video, I will show you how to share this with the world. Until next time, this is Tom Grissom. Keep on learning.